Health certainly remained a very important issue. And while there has been, we've really been operating in an environment that's been focused on kind of reducing spending in the state and reducing the Medicaid rolls in many ways, despite that environment, I think we saw certainly some important wins during our legislative session. And so there's also, of course, a lot of stuff happening at the federal level. And so I am going to attempt to give you like the 5-minute version of all of that. But hopefully you'll have a chance to ask some questions later and maybe we can dive a little bit more into detail. But just, so here's some of the big things that happened in the state during legislative session. One of the ongoing issues that we've been dealing with for quite a while in our state, children and adults with disabilities not having sufficient home and community-based options. So essentially for those families who'd like to be able to provide the care that their family member needs in their community-based setting, oftentimes don't have that option, and there's a heavy reliance on facility-based care. So we saw some important steps occur during this session to move some money that had once actually been used for a limited number of adults to have access to health care, but now since we have Medicaid expansion, that money is sitting there. And so that was shifted over to expand the number of slots on the home and community-based services waiver. It's only expected to provide about 500 people with that care, but again, 500 people is a pretty significant area of progress. If you look at sort of where we've come from, where you have folks who, you know, on average might be on that waiting list for 7 years. I've heard some folks as many as 10. So it's a step in the right direction as the state continues to make progress. Another big area, and hopefully you'll get to stay around for Representative Pilkington to hear him talk more about this on the panel. So the state is really shifting the way that we pay for care. That's been happening for a long time. There's been a huge debate over the last couple of years around whether we move towards a managed care model. And so we really kind of moved forward with what's more of sort of a hybrid. It's similar to managed care, but I think in response to hearing from local providers, hearing from families, the state moved forward with a proposal that attempts to put at least some ownership and control on local providers. And so instead of having a large health managed care company kind of saying we're going to coordinate care and do it within a certain budget, there's some ownership at the local provider level, but basically doing that same thing. As you can imagine, that certainly sparked some concerns from us, from a consumer advocacy perspective, from many community members who are worried about if we are going to be managing care, and by the way, this is for the highest cost, highest needs population, so people diagnosed with a mental health condition and children and adults with developmental or intellectual disabilities. If we're going to be managing care and coordinating within a set budget, what does that mean in terms of people getting adequate services? And so an important balance, and I think certainly huge progress, was being able to get a consumer advisory council, that language added to that bill, so that stakeholders, consumers will have a voice, and also being able to ensure that there's some patient bill of rights language included in that bill. There's a lot more work to happen on that in terms of the actual rollout of that change, but certainly an important shift in our healthcare system. So, you know, one of